Joining for an insightful afternoon with top medical experts. They share their thoughts on topics such as flu, heart attack, asthma, and diabetes. Wellness events are good at helping people adopt and maintain healthy behaviors, and they're also helping how to have a better attitude towards fitness.
So, sakit jud na na ay chronic hyperglycemia or taas na sugar, which can affect sa imong carbohydrate, fat, and protein metabolism, resulting from defects sa insulin secretion, insulin action. Ato na siya expound further sa sunod na akong mga slides. So usually, ang blood sugar, dili siya mubalik kung normal. So, money siya kung unsa pagkuha sa diabetes or unsay mga kausa ani. So, pwede siyang lack of insulin na atay insulin hormone na siya gikan sa atong pancreas, part sa lawas mismo. So, tanan-tana ay insulin production, no? Or usahay, dili na siya mutalab. Muna siya yung disulti niya, hindi tumatalab. Hence, the body cannot use the sugar. So, mapansin niyo or nakadumog tingali mo na ang uban, mudaot silang maayo, di ba? Tapos, pwede ninyong inlon. Adto ka sa doktor, pa-check up na kay basic diabetic ka, no? Mauni siyang rason kay instead na magamit sa ilahang muscle or ilahang fat cells ang ilahang sugar, mo ma-waste lang siya or dili siya magamit kay dili na mo-action ang insulin. And obviously, so ang mauni siya ang before sa estudyante pa ko, tulura jud na ang ginaisgutan.
Disorders of the blood vessels and the heart. An acute coronary syndrome is the scientific name for a heart attack, and it is a type of cardiovascular disease. It happens when a blood vessel supplying the heart is suddenly blocked and compromises the muscle of the heart. Just because the heart pumps all the blood does not mean that it does not need its own blood supply. The heart has three main vessels to carry oxygen and nutrients to its muscles. A heart attack is just like a traffic jam. Because of the obstruction in the artery, the flow of blood is critically diminished and the heart muscle beyond the narrow portion of the artery is compromised. And when this happens, the manifestations can be quite recognizable. Squeezing, usually severe chest pain that is located under the breastbone. That may radiate to the arms, neck, jaw, upper abdomen, and between the shoulder blades. It can be precipitated by exertion and relieved by rest, but very often it persists even at rest. And when it does that, that's a very, very bad sign. There may also be difficulty in breathing, and there may be nausea with sweating. But if anything like that happens, know that this is a medical emergency and it requires an immediate visit to the emergency room. But there are also times when the manifestation of a heart attack are sudden. There may just be a mild difficulty of breathing or even unusual fatigue. There may even be symptoms of hyperacidity, burping, dizziness, or palpitation. But invariably, however, victims of a heart attack report a feeling of doom, a terrible anxiety, or a scared feeling. Then again, not all chest pain is a heart attack. Some are benign, but others are life-threatening, even when not related to the heart. The important thing is, when you have a chest pain, do not let it go. Consult the doctor so he can at least have an opportunity to rule out that heart attack. Now, it is more likely to be a heart attack if there are risk factors for heart disease. A risk factor is a characteristic that increases the chances of developing the disease. For heart attack, these include diabetes, high blood pressure, overweight, low physical fitness or sedentary lifestyle, smoking, high cholesterol, and strong family history of heart disease. The thing is, the more risk factor one has, the risk of heart attack does not merely double or triple. The increase in risk is logarithmic, and these risk factors are generally divided into non-modifiable and modifiable. Non-modifiable risk factors are acts of God. There is nothing we can do about them. For example, men above 55 and women above 65 are at higher risk than younger people. Men are more at risk than women. And if there is a first degree or a second degree relative who has had a partner...
The best part of this event is I won the minor raffle prize worth of 1,000 pesos Watson's gift card.
Have a picture? Control our intake of saturated fat.
If you want to create good health, then it all starts with small decisions you have make each and every day. And one of the best places to start is by feeding your mind positive words. A healthy lifestyle not only changes your body, it changes your mind, your attitude, and your mood. Thank you for watching my video. Please give it a thumbs up if you like. And don't forget to subscribe and share it with your friends and family. Bye!